Hi, I'm Peter Travers, the movie critic for Rolling Stone, and we're going to talk about movies. And I'm going to depress you right away, because look at the movies. You can go see the Hannah Montana, Miley Cyrus concert film in 3D, if you're crazy, you can go and see it. Or you could go see Eva Longoria Parker in Over Her Dead Body, which has to be, even though this is just the first month of 2008, the worst comedy of 2008. Nothing is going to beat this for bad. So what's my advice for you to do this weekend? It's to, out of respect for Heath Ledger, to go rent or Netflix or do it however you get your hands on them, some Heath Ledger movies. And the first one I'm going to talk about is A Knight's Tale, because this was a movie that he made that made him the poster boy, the pretty boy with the blonde hair and the ringlets, and he hated everything about it. This was the first time that I had met Heath Ledger, and he said to me, "It's not like I dislike this movie, but I could see what they want to do with me. It's all about me, and that I'm blonde, and I'm pretty, and I'm gonna make a lot of blonde, pretty movies, and if I have to do this, I think I'd rather quit and just go back to the farm. I hate it so much." He did not, however, hate the movie, and he had no reason to. A lot of you remember this, that this is the 14th century, he's jousting, he's doing a lot of stuff, and what works better than anything is Heath Ledger, because he's having a great time. You skip after that to Monster's Ball. And when we think of Monster's Ball, we think Halle Berry and Billy Bob Thornton. Halle Berry won the Academy Award for this movie. Look at it again and watch Heath Ledger having only the third lead in the movie. He plays Billy Bob Thornton's son. Billy Bob is a prison guard, and Heath Ledger, like him, is trying to follow in his father's footsteps. But in the moment where he's about to lead a criminal to be executed, and the criminal is played by P. Diddy himself, he breaks down. He's walking there, and he disgraces his father, disgraces his family. Daniel Day-Lewis, when he received his SAG Award for There Will Be Blood, gave a speech about Heath Ledger and what a great actor he was, and mentioned Monster's Ball specifically, because he said, "I watched him, and I wanted to follow him. He was the character I wanted to be with." So you watch it now. Watch it again, concentrating on Heath Ledger, and see if you don't agree. I think this is a character actor's performance, which Heath Ledger, even in his 20s, always wanted to be. He was never interested in the star system. So now we're going to move ahead to Brokeback Mountain, the movie that gets Heath Ledger an Academy Award nomination for Best Actor. But look at this performance, and not just the gay angle of it, that he and Jake Gyllenhaal are lovers. There was all the sensational coverage of this, but what we're seeing Ledger play is a guy who's feeling love for the first time in his life for a guy. And he can't express it. He can't do anything to express it. But he's feeling it, and we see it through his eyes, through his posture, through everything that he's doing. There's a scene at the end of Brokeback Mountain where he is in Jake Gyllenhaal's room and Jake isn't there anymore. And he's looking at his shirts and he's basically touching them. He's actually basically getting the scent of them. He's trying to bring somebody to life in a room who isn't present in that room anymore. There's no way, if you talk to any actor when they talk about the great young actors of their time, that wouldn't choose that moment in Brokeback Mountain to say, "Look at all Heath Ledger could do." The last movie that he made is The Dark Knight, a Batman movie in which he plays the Joker and in which he seems to be behind makeup that shows great sadness, great depression, and a great sense of violence. People that I've spoken to who have seen pieces of this movie have said this might be the best performance he ever gave. However the circumstances turn out that Heath Ledger died, it's not how he's going to be remembered. He will not be remembered for the mistakes he made. He's going to be remembered for the movies he made. And those movies are the things that will endure. I'm Peter Travers.